Good morning. It's the 1st of June today, and I thought it was about time we did a little plot tour, the first one of the year. So if you'd like to join me, I'll show you around. This is the potato patch. As you can imagine, I'm pretty happy about it. It's looking fantastic. I've got three types of potatoes in this patch. I've just put all my potatoes together in one area. This is one big border that we created this year, so it's a new border. I've got two rows of first earlies, which are, I can never remember the name. Home Guard, that's the variety. We grew them last year and they were very nice. I'm hoping to have more success this year as we didn't get a big crop last year. These gigantic plants are, I believe, Maris Piper. I've kind of forgotten what main crop I planted, but I think it's Maris Piper. I really need to earth these up, but I just keep forgetting. But they're huge, doing really well. And finally, last couple of rows are pink fir apples. They were little potatoes that I saved from a crop I had last year, and I've just pushed them back in the ground, and yeah, they're doing all right. In a little narrow bed that we also created this year, next to the potatoes, we've got all kinds of things. It's not exactly as it's going to be, this border, just yet, but this is its first year, so I've just pushed all kinds of things in. Got a little winter squash in there, just a spare one that I had that I pushed in. I did have some sunflowers in there, but the snail got them. I've got a red currant bush there that's got a lot of fruit on it. It's gonna give me a nice little crop, I think. Don't know whether you can see that there. And then on the other side of this border, this is the bit that's not very organized. There's a giant borage coming through there. I've got a loganberry and a tearberry in there, but they're not doing that well. And then here I've got this lovage, which is just enormous. This border here is going to be coming out. Can you see us? At the end of the year, it was a strawberry bed that I redid at the end of last year. But unfortunately, it hasn't really come to much and the strawberries haven't done too well, so I'm just going to get a very small crop of strawberries this year. I'm going to relocate them next year. I've pushed some lettuces in here just to cover the ground. I'm going to take those out today, and I've got my autumn red cabbages to put in, and I've also got some patty pan squash, which if I've got space, I'll push them in. And these are up because I'm going to net the cabbage, obviously. So at least I'm making use of the bed. It's not going to waste, even though it will be a disappointment not to get lots of nice strawberries this year. And this kind of corner here is, truth be told, getting a bit much. It's getting out of control. As I say, behind me I've got this enormous comfrey. I think the time has come, although it is flowering, I'm going to have to cut some of it back. It's just starting to overshadow some of the other borders a bit. It'll just probably go on the compost to help make it ice-rich compost. But yeah, I love it, but it's getting too big.
And my rhubarb also is colossal. This is the courgette border. I put these in probably a week ago and they're coming on nicely. I've got, I think, 5 plants in here. It's a variety called Couza, which is a prolific early and grey courgette. So I'm quite interested to see what they're going to be like. I've also got sunflowers in there, but I'm just seeing that one's being eaten. I'm going to be so mad if the slugs eat me sunflowers this year. Those two are all right. That one's getting eaten. I'm going to have a look in there after, see if I can find the culprit. So I know this border looks like it's got nothing in it but a whole pile of flowers, but there are actually things in here. I've got my winter squash in this border. I've got 3 varieties growing this year. I've got a Victor winter squash, I've got an Anna Schwartz Hubbard variety, and the other type slips my mind, I kind of think what it is. But I've got, I think, 5 plants here, or 6, and I've just got the flowers going up the sides, and they won't interfere. The flowers will be finished by the time the squash get any bigger. These are the broad beans. For the first time this year, I planted them in spring rather than autumn. I usually put them in about November. And I'm not impressed with how they're looking with this spring sowing. They're much smaller than they would have been and not as advanced. I mean, I suppose that's kind of obvious. I can't really see the advantage of putting them in spring. But I mean, they're doing all right. They're flowering. So hopefully we'll get some broad beans out of them. I'm sure we will. Got another couple of winter squash growing in the trough at the back of the allotment again this year. I've also got squash growing in the back garden at home, spread about in different places, and I've also got the remainder of my summer squash planted in the big border there at home. It's a yellow summer squash straight-necked variety that I've got there. They are coming on beautifully, and right next to them I've got 2 rows of tomatoes, which I hope will do all right down there. I've got Moneymaker, I've got Gardener's Delight, and I think I've also got some tumbling cherry tomatoes in it. This is the onions. They're doing all right, but again, they're starting to bolt. I think from now on, I'm going to start to try to grow my onions from seed. I've only ever used onion sets to grow onions. The red onions are notorious for bolting from sets, and yeah, yellow onions, people don't seem to find that problem, but I always have every time. And even though I can see the onions are still just small golf ball sized, some of the plants are starting to bolt. So yeah, I'm pretty fed up with that. I think as I say, from next year I'm going to start to do my onion from seed. Also in this border, I've got some broccoli, which is getting eaten by the slugs. I've got beetroot, and I've got some more broad beans down at the far end. Oh, I tell you what I've also got, which I keep forgetting about. I don't know whether you'll be able to see in this long line coming down here. Excuse the weeds. I've got spring onions, which I just scattered a long line of them. And they're coming on lovely. I've also got my garlic, which shouldn't be too much longer, hopefully, maybe another month or so before it's ready. I've already had the scapes off it, and I've chopped them finely, and I've put them in the freezer to use with omelettes or whatever. I tried to have a little dig down, but I couldn't really see how far on they were, but I'm hoping for a decent crop there. This is the brassica cage. I'm quite pleased with how we've managed to put this together. I've got these small plastic or rubber attachments at the end of each piece of bamboo, and they're like 4-way, and you can attach bamboo into each one. I got the tip to get these off a channel called Nick the Gardener. His cages were a bit more fancy than mine. It's in the construction, I always fall down. I'm never very good at that, but it's working and I'm pleased with them. Inside the brassica cage, I've got a whole pile of cabbages. again, I've forgotten the variety. I should look this up before I do the video, shouldn't I? They're just a nice summer cabbage, I know that. And I've got some kales and some broccolis and some giant goose foot as well. So yeah, it's all looking nice in there.
Next up, I've got this very mixed border. I like this border, it looks so pretty.
So starting at the back of this border, I've got this row of sorrel, which is going to seed now. I'm just letting it do its own thing. It's a perennial. I've transplanted these three plants from elsewhere earlier this year, and they should fill this whole strip back here. Sorrel's a very nice plant to go for with your salads. If you pick the younger leaves, they're just a nice sharp lemony flavour. When the leaves get a bit bigger, not so much. Give them ones to the hens. Next, I've got a row of chives. Then we've got some bright lights chard coming along, and then I've got chard going down that whole first row. Too much, I know. We certainly won't eat that amount. We'll eat some of it. A lot of it, again, as I say, goes to the hens, and they enjoy it all year round. Next row is a row of beetroot. Not sure how that's coming along. I tend not to have a great lot of success with beetroot. I've got two types growing this year. I've got Solyndra and I've got Bolt Hardy. Yeah, so I've got a second row going down there. They look a bit crowded. I might thin them out. And then this red one here is Aurac, or it's like a tree spinach variety. Again, nice in salads. Just looks pretty, I think. Pretty on the plate and pretty in the border. This is one of my borders which I'm particularly pleased with. It's my bean border. So this is the peas in the front row, which I had such a lot of trouble getting to germinate. I think a lot of people, for whatever reason, had the same issue this year. Anyway, they're in. What I managed to germinate, they're in, and they're doing fine now. I netted them because the pigeons were playing havoc with everything at the time when I planted them. But really, I want to get this netting off now because the peas are climbing up the netting rather than up the framework. But I'm a bit worried if I take it off, the pigeons will come. So we'll see what I do.
And after the peas, I've just got row upon row of beans, all different varieties, and they're all doing beautifully. I'm really happy about it. I've got runner beans, Scarlet Emperor, and a white variety running up this first row here. After that, I've got some dwarf runner beans called a variety called Jackpot. Or do you know what? I don't even know where any of them are now. I think they're all just mixed in. And I've got lots of French beans. I've got dwarf French beans. I've got climbing French beans. I've got purple ones and green ones. And everything's doing beautifully. At the end of that bean border, I've got these celery that I planted out a while ago. They're a self-blanching variety. I'm pretty happy with how they're doing. They look healthy, they look strong. Just got to wait for them to grow now. I have also got these tree cabbages at the end of this border. These apparently grow large, so we'll see how big these ones grow. And you just harvest the leaves become enormous. So I'm really looking forward to seeing what this crop is like.
I hope you enjoyed that little look around the allotment. I didn't show you every single thing because it would get a bit tedious. But as you say, there's a lot going on. Almost everything is in the ground now. It's just a case of sitting and waiting for it to grow. We've had a lot of rain this last month. All of me, it's poured with rain here at any rate. I don't know what it's been like where you are. What we need now is some hot sun to start everything growing. Anyway, hope your veg is growing well, and we'll catch you on the next one. Bye.